Welcome to sunny Winter Haven, Florida. I'm Lane Dog Bowers, and I am so excited about what I'm going to talk to you about today. I am going to show you probably my favorite trick that I ever learned. It's probably the hottest trick on the internet right now. Everybody wants to know how to do it, and it's side slides. And I'm real excited about side slides because when I first started playing with them, the only guy in the world who knew how to do them told me that he wouldn't teach it to me. It's a signature trick, not going to do it. That's not the way we roll around here. Around here, we show everybody we can how to do it for free. And this is why I'm helping you out today. And I'm real excited because I found a couple of key breakthroughs that it's not about me and my barefoot. You know, I have figured it out. But by teaching enough people, I've had some great breakthroughs that are going to help you do your first side slide you ever tried. Very excited about it, and I'm going to break it down into probably about 4 videos. So get pumped up, and I am going to create sideslides.com, and that'll take you to the footersedge.com, right to a section on side slides. Have a bunch of information there. Very excited about it. Now, as you know, with everything I teach, it boils down into number one, let's have a plan. Number one is we're going to figure out how to do it on dry land. If you don't have any concept on dry land, why would you try it on the water? So I'm going to show you on this first video. It's going to be about dry land, how to get it on land. I want your head wrapped around the concept. I want you to learn the foot position. And I'm going to show you a bunch of great things that are going to help you not only safely learn a side slide, but it's going to help you really enjoy it, and it'll really transform your skiing. I'm very excited. Okay. Most people, who's ready for a side slide? Here's what I'd say. If you can barefoot, that doesn't necessarily make you ready for a side slide. I prefer to see you learn good forward form, good front one foot, bouncy trouncy in your form. And I would have said in the past, probably because it was so hard for me to learn it when no one was sharing any information, I would have said front to back, some back one foot, but now I don't think I'm gonna say that anymore. I think I'm gonna say anybody, you know, if you can do a one foot, great. Even if you can't do a one foot, the way I'm going to show you is going to help you, and I think it's for everyone. Start practicing on land. Get your hopes up as high as you can. Get the arms with the right information, and then I'm going to help your barefoot miracle become a reality. Okay, here's the deal. First thing we got to learn about side slide is, let me just talk in general. I'm not going to go into posture glide and too much, but let's face it. I've talked about that a lot. It's well documented. If you don't understand what that stuff is, all you got to do is email me or call me. I'll send you all that information for free. But glide is very important. And let's talk about forwards. When you're doing your forwards barefoot and you're actually gliding on everything but on your foot, everything but the ball of your foot. Let me turn my foot in here. You can angle down a little, Alec. Is you're skiing all the way up to but not on the ball of your foot. Backwards, we're skiing all the way up to but not on the heel of our foot. In a side slide, we're actually skiing on the sides of our feet. So you're basically take the foot roughly in half. It's not actually in half, it's more of a, but it's kind of down the middle. I'll explain a little bit more, but that's what a side slide is. Now, how do you set up for side slide? Great news is, if you get hurt doing this on land, this ain't your trick, but I think I can help anybody who's interested in it. Watch this. On dry land, it's safe. That's what we like to start with. And I walked around when I was learning this trick. Everywhere I walked, bam, I'd hit the position. I just was trying to get it in my head. Where am I supposed to be? And I was real nervous, but you don't have to be nervous anymore because I'm going to show you the safe way to do it. So here we go. First thing I need you to do is get up and get in good form, but just be soft in your knees. This is not a stiff-legged trick. It looks stiff-legged when you see it, but it's very important for your own safety. You learn to keep your knees nice and soft. So you just kind of get up nice and soft. And then when you're ready to do a side slide, what we're going to do is we're first going to learn the foot position. I'll show you both directions here. When you do the side slide, what you're really doing is kind of a, you kind of like you're doing a bouncy trouncy here, and then you rotate your heels forward. And I want you, the first lesson is imagine that straight under this handle is a line that matches this handle. If there were a shadow coming down and it drew a line right under this handle, that's our imaginary line. When you're skiing forward, you know, your feet, your toes are up towards that imaginary line, okay? So now in a side slide, what I want to show you do is the side slide, we're going to keep our toes towards that line, and then we're going to turn. If you're turning to the right, your right heel should go just past that line, and your left foot is going to go up on that line, totally parallel with that line. But on this foot, I want your foot slightly rotated forward. The easiest foot to side slide on is the pinky toe edge. So if you're turning to the right, your left foot will turn a lot easier than this right foot. That's the key. A lot of people that do side slides out there do a hockey stop like this, and we don't want to do that. What I want you to do is think of that imaginary line on dry land, get bouncy, trouncy, and rotate. And then to your, if you're turning to your right heel would slide just in front of that line, and your left foot can be up and on that line. Then once you're in it, I want you to just be soft in your knees. What's gonna happen is you gotta learn not to do a side slide like this where your foot's following behind you. The temptation in side is to sit low and back. So most people, if you're trying it without the right information in the right order, you'd go like this, and you'd probably try and sit low to protect yourself. That's not gonna help you in a side slide. What you wanna do is soften your knees, rotate, and then once you get here on dry land, then just nice and soft in your knees. And then you wanna kinda just adjust your feet a little bit so they're up by that imaginary line. Again, the left foot turning easy because that's the pinky toe-edge forward. The harder foot is this one. So we have to keep it forward, keep it from coming back here. And then be nice and soft in your knees. How wide should you do it? Later on, I'm gonna show you, we're gonna practice bringing them close and bringing them wide, but I want you to think about like shoulder width and wide with both hands on the handle for right now, because I don't want you to think about sitting down and back. Now, I'll show you the other way, just so you can see. If you were feel like it might feel better to turn to the left, nice bouncy trouncy, and rotate, and keep that left foot forward to that imaginary line, and your right foot sideways, and then nice and soft in your knees. Nice and soft in your knees. And that's what's gonna keep you soft, but keep the pressure. If your foot comes back too far behind this imaginary line, the water is gonna grab at that edge and try and yank it underwater. You wanna keep your feet, you do have to have a little bit of pressure forward, but then you wanna be soft. And the way to get the right amount of pressure is good foot position and good body position. You don't wanna be bent over, you don't wanna pull in too much. You wanna just get a feeling of a nice, easy rotation like that. And the other way, nice, easy rotation like that. And then nice and soft in your knees. That's the basis for doing a side slide. I want you to practice that. Get on a handle, get nice and soft. Make sure you're not sitting down, you're not falling away, you're not getting heavy, you're not getting light. Feet shoulder width apart, nice and soft in your knees. And then that's how we're gonna do the dry land practice. In the next video, I'm gonna show you the critical steps to setting up your boom height correctly and a real big breakthrough in shoe skis that's gonna just really blow your mind and make this safe and easy for you to do on your very first try. But first we're gonna get all the information first. Don't run off and go try these on your own. I don't want you to get hurt. I am very excited for you. I'm expecting a miracle for you. Have a great day.